What's up, guys? So today I'm doing a video that you guys have been requesting that I do for quite a few years now, and that's an official house tour video. Now, the reason that I've never done one of these before is because, as you guys know, my house is still not finished yet. It's still incomplete. There's still renovations that are yet to be done. It's still quite empty, to be honest. But I thought, you know what? I'm just gonna show you guys around, show you guys how it's looking at the moment. And to be honest, I'm really lucky to be able to spend quarantine in such a beautiful big house. So here it is. This is my house. I'm gonna start off with my favorite room in the house, which is the main living area. This is pretty much the only room in the house where I've really started adding some of my own personal touches to it. One of the first things that I did to this room was just add a touch of color. I love color. My favorite color is blue, so I tried to make the room pop with some blue cushions. I got this little guy over here, Frank the Flamingo. Yes, I name my cushions, I'm weird. I've got a painting up here by my favorite graffiti artist in the world. His name is Dame. I've been into him since I was a teenager, and I think that just fits perfectly with the pillows. I've put up these picture frames, which if you look up close, they're actually record covers. This is a record cover of A Tribe Called Quest's last album. I'm a huge Tribe Called Quest fan. I really love these lights. I picked these lights out. And one of my favorite things about this room is the high ceiling. I just love this high ceiling.
It gets more natural light than any other room in the house.
I've got my bookshelf over here with bits and bobs on it. Got all these puzzles up top because the kids really love to do puzzles. I've got my Cause figurines, some photos of me and my kids. I got this YouTube play button that I pinched from a YouTube party I went to in LA. I've got this Obelix figurine. I used to read Asterix comics all the time when I was a kid, and Obelix was my favorite character. Over here we have my most worn shoes. As you guys know, I'm a bit of a sneakerhead, so I've got a lot of shoes sitting at the front door. I got my Jordan 4 cements. These are one of my all-time favorite shoes. Got a couple of pairs of Yeezys there. I got another pair of Jordan 4s. These are one of my favorite shoes too. This is my kids' playroom, which, to be honest, we don't really play in here a lot. This is the robot that Zoe gave Ava the first time that she met her. Both of the kids still play with this robot. He gets a lot of playtime, so Zoe really picked out a good toy. We've got Woody sitting over here, who's one of Zoe's favorite toys. We've got Louise from Louisiana, Peppa Pig and George. We've got the Doc McStuffins baby, Cece, Emma. We've got this genie lamp up here. This is something that I got Ava when I was in Dubai.
I showed it to her on FaceTime and she was so incredibly excited to get it because she thought it was a real genie lamp. And I felt so horrible because when she got it, she started rubbing it and she was so devastated that a real genie didn't come out of it because I told her I got her a real genie lamp. I kind of thought I was just playing a game. She took it literal, and she's over it now, but for quite a while, she's like, "Dad, you told me you were getting me a real genie. Where's my genie?" I think she's low-key still waiting for it. The reason that we don't play in that playroom all that much is because we spend a lot more time playing in this playroom. This used to be the second living area, but it's just turned into a giant playroom. We still have Ava's pink castle that I made for her on her birthday. In all honesty, I expected that to last about a week. I did not expect them to take care of it, but they love it so much that they've been really, really gentle with it. It's still standing. We still spend a lot of time playing in it. We had the Barbie dream house over here, which is Zoe's favorite toy. She spends hours playing in this thing. We just play with the dolls. Ava plays with it as well, but Zoe's definitely a lot more into it than Ava is. We got Zoe's slide that she got for Christmas. She uses that a lot as well. Over here we have the kitchen. We have the LG Knock Knock fridge, which I absolutely love. Although the one and only thing that I don't like about this fridge is it's not magnetic, so you can't put magnets on it. And I really do miss having magnets. So instead, I've just Started sticky taping photos to it. The plan is to completely cover the fridge in photos of me and the kids and drawings of theirs. Ava's really into Lego, so I've got this Frozen Lego castle up here that Ava and I built together. I've got a Tintin figurine over here that I got when I was in Singapore. I got my plant named Frederick, who I have surprisingly managed to keep alive. Speaking of which, Frederick, I need to water you today. I will get onto that. I've got my limited edition Friends Lego set. Ava loves playing with this one, but she has no idea who Friends are, so this is just the coffee shop Lego set to her. I have a very mismatched table setting going on right now. Basically, because I don't anticipate on living in this house forever and I'm gonna sell it, I don't plan on having such a big house when I move out of this house, and I can't see the next house that I own being big enough for a table like this. So while I really love this table, I feel like this table probably won't end up coming with me. I really, really do love this table. Like, as you can see, it has these really interesting industrial legs underneath it, which I think are really cool. But the chairs that I have at this table right now are actually outdoor furniture. They're mismatched, but they do the job, and I just feel like it's a waste of money to go out and buy chairs for a table that I don't think will be in my life for all that long. So I'm about to show you guys the hidden area of the house that I never film in, and that's because these rooms are pretty much demolished, still need to be finished. At the moment, I just don't really have the money to complete this renovation. To be completely honest, this house has had so much money thrown at it. This is, I don't even know what you really call this area. This is like the washroom of the downstairs bathroom. And then as you come in here, we have the toilet room. There's a shower that goes over there, or that's gonna be going back over there. As you can see, all the tiles have been pulled off the wall, but not off the floor at the moment. The room is pretty trashed. I've got photography gear down here, tripods, lights, stuff like that. A bunch of just things that I'm storing, like boxes and suitcases. And then this is the laundry, which is pretty much the same case. It's kind of half finished, tiles pulled off the wall. The sink hasn't been finished. The plumbing needs to be reworked. There's a lot of stuff that still needs to be finished in here. It's a bit of a mess. So I still have those two rooms to go in terms of renovation. So the next part of the tour is the upstairs area. And this is one of my favorite parts of the house. I love that you can just look over at the living room. You can look down here as well. I just think this feature is really, really cool. I'm currently standing in what is technically the games room, I think it's called. There's literally nothing in this room. This room is completely empty. The only thing I really have is a couple of picture frames on the wall. I think I'm gonna get some more pictures similar to this and continue it going along the wall, maybe like another two or three pictures. Through here is my bedroom, which is pretty big. I've started just trying to add some more color in my bedroom. As part of my morning routine, I always wake up and make my bed first thing, just so that I can feel like I started my day by accomplishing something. So my bed is always nicely made. Got a little photo of Zoe the day that she was born next to my bed. This room, it's pretty simple. There's not really a lot of stuff in here. I ideally want to get a big picture frame above my bed. I have a photo that I took on my drone in the Barossa Valley that I really want to get enlarged and put up on top of my bed. So that's what's eventually going to be there. Through here, we have a walk-in closet. So these are all my knits and things like that. I'm a little bit OCD when it comes to my clothes, so everything is color coordinated. As you guys know, I love my hats, so when I'm having a bad hair day, I just grab one of these. Got a bunch of jackets, got my suits, got my Jordans going in numerical order, starting with the Chicago ones. I'm not really a big fan of twos. I don't have any threes up here. It goes all the way to the fours, my all white fours. I love these fives. These have always been one of my favorite Jordans. They just re-released recently with the Nike Air on the back. So I was really excited to get a pair of these. And then of course I've got the black suede ones as well. And these have always been one of my favorite Jordans, the black infrared sixes. They're a little bit dusty, I need to give them a clean. But these are the shoes that really got me into Jordans as a kid. I could never afford them, so being able to get them as an adult, it was just a really great feeling. I've got another pair of sixes, the Paris collaboration. I've got the Jordan 8s, which as a kid, these were the first ever Jordans that I ever got. This is where my love of sneakers really started. And when Ava was born, I got her a pair of the baby Jordan 8s, and then Zoe wore them as well. And now, sadly, neither of them fit into them. So they're just sitting there. Then I've got this closet over here. This is all the clothes that I wear the most. So I've got some of my chunkier knits up there. My jackets that I wear the most. This is my favorite leather jacket. This is a Saint Laurent black leather jacket that I got in Japan. It's just such a classic jacket. It's something that I'll keep for the rest of my life. I love that jacket. And I've also got my Bodeskins jacket, which is much more affordable. And to be honest, I probably wear this one a lot more because it is a lot more casual than the Saint Laurent one. The Saint Laurent one is a lot dressier. I got a bunch of other jackets. Got more shoes. I got my Rick Owens, got some more Jordans with the matching kids version, my Chelsea boots, my Vans. And then I've got all my favorite t-shirts sitting over here. Got my favorite hoodies, got, you know, pants that I wear a lot. And then through here I have the ensuite. And then as you guys can see, we have where the sink should be, but it is still completely empty. So that's something that still needs to be done, a sink put in there. And then this room will be finished. The next room on the tour is what is now my office. It used to be Zoe's bedroom. As you can see, there's still some of the paint splatter pattern on the wall. It is now my office because, to be honest, Zoe never actually slept in this room. She always slept in my bed. So I just felt like it didn't really make sense having a bedroom that wasn't being used, and Ava wanted her to move into her room anyway. So I moved Zoe's cot into Ava's room, turned this into my office, and still obviously store kids' clothes and stuff in here. But there's not really a lot going on in this room. I don't know if I'm gonna do anything with it. It's just a nice, quiet space where I can come and do my work. I have my daily goals sitting on the wall in front of me. So as the day goes on, I like to tick off my goals. Now through here, we have the main bathroom. It's all gray, as you guys can see. I don't really know how to describe it as opposed to it being a bathroom. I actually went and took some photos at a pink lake, and I printed out a series of them, and I was gonna put all three of them along this wall, but then when I put them up, the colors were just too vibrant for the soft grays of this room, and they just didn't really work. So that was a bit of a fail. So instead, that photo has ended up behind the door in my toilet. It's just a calming photo to look at when you're on the toilet. I really love the way that these turned out, and I gave away the high resolution pictures on Instagram when I first put them up, and like 3,000 people downloaded them, which I thought was really cool. So maybe I'll give those away again in the future. Here is the spare room. Once again, nothing really going on in here. So through here, we have the girls' room. You guys have seen this before. Ava has her Emma bedspread. I put a couple of toys on it just to sort of spruce things up, make it look a little bit more girly. Ava has this little llama who sits next to her bed, and this is her piggy bank. So when she does chores, she gets coins. Me and the kids like to read a lot of books, so we have some of their favorite books up here. I've got Zoe's cot over here. Realistically speaking, she's probably about ready for an actual kitty bed pretty soon. Although in saying that, she still doesn't consistently sleep in her cot, let alone a kitty bed just yet. Just like my closet, they're all color coordinated. Got t-shirts down here, jackets there. Got a photo of me and Ava here, photo of Zoe and Grandpa there. Over here we have Ava's makeup table where she likes to sit and pretend to do her makeup. And sometimes I let her play with this this kitty makeup that she somehow talked me into letting her buy. And over here we have Zoe's makeup table where she plays with her pretend makeup and somehow always talks me into letting her do my makeup with it. We have this ginormous balcony which really desperately needs some outdoor furniture. Speaking of outdoors, this is by far my favorite part of the house. This is the part of the house that when I sell this house, I'm gonna miss this part, because the kids and I just spend so much time playing out here. Finding a house in the suburbs with a backyard this size was no easy task. There's so many fun things that we get up to in the backyard, from riding bikes around here to playing on the trampoline to playing basketball. Zoe will literally play on this swing set for hours on end. We have this playhouse that my dad and I put together, and the kids love using the slide and playing hide and seek inside of it and playing hide and seek behind all of these trees. There's this big weird thing in the middle of the backyard, which to be honest, I don't really understand what its purpose is. So this is all fake grass around it. So in order to get rid of that, I had to redo all of the fake grass around the whole yard, and that was just going to be really, really expensive. But ideally, I would prefer it if this big monstrosity was not there. And yes, I know, I really need to do some weeding. And last but not least, this is my other favorite room in the house, which I'm quite embarrassed to show you guys because it is an absolute mess at the moment. I really need to get this room organized. The rest of my house is pretty organized, but this room is a bit of a monstrosity. But it houses my two babies, my Honda S2000 and my Porsche 911. I am an absolute car nut. I'm more into cars than I am household things. So that's why I would say that this is my other favorite room in the house, because sometimes I just come out here and look at my cars, and that's why I really, really need to get this room organized again. Anyway, that is the end of my official house tour. I'm sorry it took me so long to do it. I hope you guys are all doing well, all staying safe, all staying indoors. And if you like this video, make sure you hit the thumbs up, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.